Greetings, my dear friends. This is Stan once again. And for those of you who don't know me, for you, this is an introduction. Again, my name is Stan Houston. I'm a longtime storyteller, teacher, international broadcaster, business performance coach, and now the co-founder and leader of what we call the Christian Entrepreneur Network. And we are going and growing. It's tough. It's hard. It's costly. But like everything worthwhile, the progress is slow, and sometimes the pain seems intense, but we are finding that God is finding a good place for what we are all about, and perhaps you could find a place with us. We now are going out and finding people who represent us in a position of advocacy. And first of all, I'm looking for someone in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. As you become more and more familiar with the Christian Entrepreneur Network, you will find that we are worldwide digital, but we're going to start in three locations in the heartland of the United States: Minneapolis, St. Paul, Omaha, Lincoln, and right in the middle, that very unique place, a small city called Sioux Falls, where it just so happens there is almost a convergence, a perfect storm in a positive way of people of faith, people who have entrepreneurial spirits, of a community and a large supportive business community that wants to go and grow and make Sioux Falls, as we say, one of the real centers of the growing startup world. And we would like to say it is kind of the spirit home of the startup nation. And I'm looking for somebody who would step forward and join our team. And let me put it this way. They're on fire. They're sparking. They're fully alive. And they are seeking to be led by God's full spirit force. Does that describe you? I hope it will describe the people that we are, and hopefully the people who will join us. They're on fire. They're sparking. They're fully alive. And it's because they are seeking to be full of God's spirit force. They pray a lot. Prayer is vital to what we are about. And one of the things we seek in prayer is, first of all, that we would have wisdom, that we would have courage, and that we would have kindness. That's our big three. We pray for wisdom, courage, and kindness. And we also want to make sure that we are seeking God's creative power in our lives and our business. Now, what I'd like to do is ask you, if you're up to it, to consider this position. And we kind of call it CCMMSS. CMS2. That's our position. And what it means is you're kind of the chief coaching and connecting person. Coaching. We are a coaching and teaching and learning company. A coaching and connecting person. You are ready to do media and marketing and service and sales. Now, did you see the order? We're going to coach. We're going to connect. We're going to use the media to make our mark. We're going to serve people first. And we believe if you serve people first, the sales will follow. Coaching, connecting, caring, learning how to use the media to do effective, ethical, powerful internet and personal marketing, performance marketing, and we serve people. And in the service, we get the sale. Unlike most people who just want to sell and then service, we believe that the kind of people we can serve best are those who we will take the risk of serving them first. And in doing that, we deserve the opportunity to make the sale. We are a 501c3. We have been qualified to be a nonprofit, in a sense, educational institution. But we are also not only involved in seeking sponsorship and donations, but we have products and services and events because we want to make sure that we are truly entrepreneurs ourselves. We're not just pretending to be entrepreneurs and asking people to pay for our entrepreneurialism. We are going to help people be entrepreneurs by being entrepreneurs ourselves, and we will raise what we need to sustain our work by the sales and service and the things we do for others. It's a new paradigm. It is the best of the sponsoring and donation, but it is also related to the entrepreneurial enterprise, make a difference. By the way, who did I learn that from? St. Paul. He was a missionary entrepreneur. He financed his mission work by the business enterprise he had. We believe that Jesus is the master entrepreneur, and we are called to follow the master entrepreneur. And if you would like to help this organization go and grow, we would be grateful. Let me give you just a brief idea. We have shown that what we're about is the diamond. We love the diamond idea. You know what? A diamond is something that was simply a piece of coal under pressure for a long, long time, and then somebody had to cut and polish it and make it beautiful and hard and durable. And so we have what we call the five-point diamond, and everything flows out of that. First of all, we have to have the mind of the maker. What are the prayers? The prayers. The prayer and the prayers and the principles, the beliefs and the behaviors and the blessings that we must have in our heart, mind, and spirit to become true Christian entrepreneurs. You got to sell. Nothing happens until somebody persuades and sells and brings value to others. And guess what? We know that, in effect, we have a way of showing you how Jesus serves, sells, and saves. Everything you've learned about selling is wrong. We will show you a secret that Jesus knew about selling. Team building, most everything you've learned is wrong. The 3-12-70 principle is one that the master entrepreneur used, and in effect, he began his enterprise, and in 3 years, he exited it, and it has grown and prospered for over 2,000 years. What is the secret Jesus knew about building a world-class company? The Bible says in many, many cases, don't be afraid. Be strong. And so this part of the diamond is that we want you to understand that God not only wants you to be an entrepreneur, but he wants you to be strong and brave and bold and probably broken. That's right. It is that combination of things that becomes the people God can use. So the mind of the maker, the master sales master, the man who understood how to build a world-class company, and we can learn that. And then, don't be afraid. Be bold and brave and strong, particularly in the broken places. And right in the middle of the diamond, because it's five-pointed, is what we call the spirit force. Term Holy Ghost is an old one. Holy Spirit is the one we use primarily today. But we've said it's a force. It's not a passive spirit that sits around kind of Buddha-like. God's spirit is a force. It's fire. It's wind. It's movement. It's power. And so, the five-pointed diamond always centers around the full spirit force that God gives to us. From all of that, we have all kinds of things that we know about strategic marketing, internet marketing, business communication, what everybody else says we can do, but we do it with a different point of view and from a different point of power, and we do it for you. We believe in treating you as the most important person in the world, because you are. And we believe that we should treat every person we meet as the most important person in the world, because they are, because God cares deeply about each and every one of us. We are important to Him. We are beloved, and we are to show that. Truly, we want to be entrepreneurs who are imitators of the master entrepreneur. Would you like to be a part of helping make this happen and making it possible? It's a 1099 entrepreneurial experience. No one's getting paid yet, but we're all in the world work of creating value to people so that we will be compensated fairly, maybe even generously as the good Lord allows, because we have done generous and good and wonderful things for other people. Because the world right now does not need any more big-time crony capitalists. It does not need any more powerful politicians. It does not need all of those things that usually happen. And as one of my friends said, we don't need more pastors in the pulpit. We need more ministers in the marketplace. And if you'd like to be a part of this growing experiment called the Christian Entrepreneur Network, and particularly those of you in the Sioux Falls area, we're going to start right there, and we're going to start with you. But then it goes and it grows, and if you'd like to know more about how you could perhaps be one of these affiliates, one of our partners, one of our colleagues in your community, we would be grateful for the opportunity to show you just how we might be able to do that. TCENglobal.org, TCENglobal.org. As I said, we are a nonprofit educational organization. Donations and sponsorship is there, but products and services for sale are also there. TCENglobal.org. I'd be happy to reach out and talk to you. You can email me at stanhusted@gmail.com, stanhusted@gmail.com. And there's a good chance that somebody showed you the link to this video. And if that's the case, they probably know how you can find more information from them and certainly find out more from me. 2020 is the year that will be crucial. We start out with a virus, which is changing things. We have presidential power all around the world, and it is a place where the marketplace is something that we as Christians need to go into. As one of my young friends said, Stan, unfortunately most of my friends don't go to church anymore, or never did, but they're all in the marketplace. And that's where we can reach them, influence them, and that's where we can create an enterprise that not only does good, does it makes a difference that matters in the world, but also brings into it the very connection to the master entrepreneur and to the life and the faith and the service and the forever eternity he gives. We have big hopes, big plans. We hope that you will join us. Again, my name is Stan Husted. Reach out to me at stanhusted@gmail.com, and we will talk. Best and blessings to you. May it go well for you. Bye for now.